Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about 5 reasons you might regret buying an inexpensive instrument. Now, not everyone's going to have my personal experiences, I understand that. So if you've had different experiences or if you found different ideas that work, put that in the comments down below because this channel is not just about an opinion, it's about sharing information. But with that in mind, let's get right into it. Number 1, do your own upgrades. If you're a person that loves working on instruments or learning to work on instruments, well then buying an inexpensive guitar and fixing it up might be a great proposition for you. The education alone could be invaluable. However, if your plan is to buy an inexpensive guitar and then take it down and have someone work on it at $35 to $65 an hour, you're going to find that this is going to become an expensive endeavor. The second problem that I see people do all the time is they buy the inexpensive guitar, but they haven't researched all of the components that's going to cost to fix the guitar up. In other words, they're in the moment and they buy this inexpensive project, and then when they get home and do the math, they realize they're going to spend a fortune. Or worse, they start spending on those parts to find out that it's a long haul before they get to where the guitar is right. In other words, make sure that you are researching what you're doing and you're already committed to the idea all the way through, so you don't end up in a situation where you've spent a lot of money and you're not happy. Number 2, figure out what you like about guitars. The neck, the way it feels, the way it sounds, the way it looks. One thing to pay attention to when you're buying inexpensive guitars is that factories have really perfected the way guitars look, spending so much time into making sure the guitar presentation is so perfect. For example, they will do many prototypes of a finish to make sure the finish is right, but they might not spend that much time in making sure the neck is the perfect feel and shaped correctly, or that the pickups are a good complement to the guitar. In other words, a lot of inexpensive guitars are going to look right more than feel right and sound right. So it's important that you put your hands on it, you listen to it, and look at the instrument before purchasing it. And that brings us into number 3. If you're new to guitar and you're buying an inexpensive guitar to get into playing, well, that makes a lot of sense. But once you've decided this is for you and you want to play, make sure that your second guitar isn't just a repackaged version of what you already have. In other words, figure out exactly what your guitar is. What are the things that you like about the guitar, and what are the things that you think need to be worked on? In other words, figure out where the next step is going to be. A lot of musicians make the mistake of buying different versions of the same instrument. What I mean by that is they'll buy different shaped guitars, for instance, but they're all on the same level of quality and playing, so that you really aren't upgrading. It's important to really pay attention to what are upgrades in an instrument when you're buying inexpensive instruments. And not all that can be dictated on price. So in other words, if you spend $200 for a guitar and you think buying a $400 guitar will give you double the value, you're going to be probably mistaken. Number 4 is probably the most important when it comes to buying inexpensive instruments. It's brand names. Brand names are very misleading because they will make an instrument that is extremely well built and high dollar, and then on the other hand, make a very low price instrument that is not very good. And there's a lot of spots in between. Now, some brands are notoriously known for only making really good high quality instruments, but that is few and far between. Most brands now eat their cake and have it too with this $100 to $5,000 price ranging system. So relying on the brand is always going to lead to some kind of remorse because you're going to think that you bought something you didn't. So what do? Well, you have to pay attention to not just what artists are playing with a brand or a friend, because when they're playing that brand, again, they can be playing a much different instrument with that same branding that what you're looking at and the price points you're starting to look at. So one of the things I recommend is being open-minded to finding instruments that may have brands that you've never heard of that might feel quality. You never know when there's a diamond in the rough. But more importantly, in today's day and age, just do some online research. You'll see a lot of great opinions on an instrument maybe you've never heard of. So in other words, don't be afraid to look at non-branded name instruments. Number 5 is what I do when I buy every single guitar I own, which is set expectations. This is a very important thing because it doesn't involve a brand, a type of instrument, a price point. It doesn't involve anything. I use this example every time. Let's say your first expectation is that the guitar must stay in tune. That's important. If the second expectation might, it has a certain sound. Maybe it needs to sound warm or bright or clear. Maybe it needs to feel comfortable in your hand. This is important to write these ideas down because what's interesting to me is you could find this instrument without even worrying about the price. In other words, let's say you set a budget of $500 and you go to a store and you find this guitar that fits every one of the criteria on your list. It's $300. Do you really need to spend an extra $200? No, you found the perfect instrument. On the other hand, what happens if you found all the instruments you found that meet expectations are out of your budget? But that tells us you're going to have to make some concessions on your expectations, or maybe save a little bit more money or shop a little harder to find that deal. The more important thing is, as I've found, that if the instrument meets your expectations, you'll always be happy with it. And there you have it, 5 things that will help you hopefully avoid buyer's remorse when buying an inexpensive instrument. Now, this is part of a series, so we'll have another video, 5 things that could give you buyer's remorse if you buy an expensive instrument, so watch for that. And as I stated before, please feel free to share your thoughts down below. I'd like to see what you guys experienced when buying inexpensive instruments, whether it be good or bad. We all kind of learn from those things. Thank you so much, and as always, until next time, know your gear.